Welcome back to the 18th part of Debugging at Scale, where system calls are no longer a blind spot in our rearview mirror. Dtrace is one of the coolest tools we can use to debug a system problem, but it usually isn't available on Linux, where we do most of our debugging for servers and containers. The strace tool also originated at Sun Microsystems, in this case in the 90s. This isn't surprising, though, as the list of technologies originating from Sun Microsystems is absolutely mind-numbing. strace is much simpler than dtrace in both usage and capabilities, for better and for worse. Since dtrace requires deep OS support, it never became an official feature of common Linux distributions, and as a result, on Linux, people use strace instead of dtrace. They aren't interchangeable and are wildly different tools, despite the name similarity and similar domains. strace is enabled thanks to the kernel feature known as ptrace. Since ptrace is already in Linux, we don't need to add additional kernel code or modules. Typically, dtrace requires deeper kernel support to get around licensing issues on Linux. It's in a separate loadable module, but that still presents some challenges. Working with strace is akin to printing a log every entry every time we make a kernel call. This creates very verbose logging for even every command you execute. As a result, you can follow what's really going on under the hood of a running process. Nowadays, strace is commonly used in Linux. It's my favorite system diagnostic tool on that platform. It's a remarkably convenient tool to work with since we can run it with no special privileges. Notice that unlike dtrace, you should keep strace away from production environments, unless the code is segregated. It carries a significant performance overhead and would bring production systems down. The most basic usage of strace is just passing the command line to it. The output of strace for this is pretty long. Let's go over a few of the lines. This is the strace command. I pass in the actual command as an argument. Notice I don't need sudo or any special tricks. Strace just works and doesn't require disabling protections. Every one of the lines below is a Linux system call. We can Google each one of them to get a sense of what's going on. Here's a simple example. Java tries to load the pthread library from the TLS directory using a system call. Open to load the file. The exit code of the system call is -1, which means that the file isn't there. Under normal circumstances, we should get back a file descriptor value from this API, positive non-zero integer. Looking in the directory, it seems the TLS directory is missing. I'm guessing that this is because of the missing Java cryptography extensions. This is probably okay, but might have been interesting in some cases. Obviously, the amount of output is overwhelming sometimes. We usually just want to see things like which file was opened and what's going on with our network calls. We can easily accomplish that by only looking at a specific system call using the -e argument. This will only show the open system calls. That means the app will run faster since it won't log as much. And we can actually read data since it isn't an unmanageable amount of output. There are many system calls you can learn and use to track many behaviors, such as this, connect, write, etc. This is only the tip of the iceberg of what you can do using strace. As you saw before, strace works great with the JVM. Since strace predates Java and is a very low-level tool. It has no awareness of the JVM. The JVM works like most other platforms and invokes system calls, which you can use to debug its behavior. However, because of its unique approach to some problems, some aspects might not be as visible with dtrace. A good example is allocation. System tools use malloc, which maps to kernel allocation logic. But Java takes a different route. It manages its own memory for efficiency and easier garbage collection logic. As a result, some aspects of memory allocation will be hidden from strace output. This can be a blessing in disguise, as the output can be overwhelming sometimes. At this time, Java threading works well with strace. But this might not be the case moving forward, as Project Loom might change the one-to-one mapping between Java threads and system threads. This might make strace output harder to pinpoint in heavy threaded applications. Strace is a fantastic tool that helps us verify low-level assumptions about our app and even about its interactions with other apps. I'm sure many of you will find yourselves using it in the future. In the next video, we'll discuss git bisect, the most important git command that's relatively unknown. If you have any questions, please use the Slack channel to ask them. Thank you.